Good job. Hello, everybody. Welcome to Happy Jams. Thanks for watching. I'm your host, Randy Lanham. Got my buddy Wayne Morse over here today. Actually, Wayne, you did episode 1 with me.
Yeah.
And now you're doing episode 10 with me. So you're going to start and end this series with me. I appreciate it. It's actually kind of your idea to started this whole thing anyway back a long time ago, doing this music for some of the nursing homes and the assisted living facilities and just the folks that, you know, might be caught inside and not able to get out a whole lot that just wants to hear some good old time music. And that's what we do on Happy Jams. We like to do some just fun music, but we try to pick some good old classic music.
Yeah,
right?
We do.
Some good old classic music. So that tune right there was called The Devil's Dream, an old fiddle tune. And Wayne, we thought we would do something cool. You and I have been doing this the past couple years, slowly been putting together a little bitty segment called Western Kentucky Music Legends. Mm-hmm. And been doing some of their music. I'm sure a lot of you all have heard of Mr. Bill Monroe, right? You probably heard of Merle Travis, right? Yeah. Thumb picker. And you probably heard of the Everly Brothers.
Yeah,
big hits, big country, and I'm sorry, rock and roll band, but they had country hits as well. And then John Prine. You know, I know he didn't live here, but he had family here around this area and wrote a huge hit called Paradise. And so we thought we would do some of their songs.
Yeah.
Kind of bring back some memories and kind of show off, because we're proud to be from this area.
Absolutely.
Area of the world and this area of Kentucky. So some famous people, some famous songs from around this area. Want to start with Blue Moon of Kentucky.
Yeah,
This is the official Kentucky State bluegrass song. Now, My Old Kentucky Home is obviously the Kentucky song, but the official Kentucky State bluegrass song is Blue Moon of Kentucky. Now, funny story, really quick story. The way that we do this is we start it as slow, like a waltz time, and then we kick it up and do it fast. So when Bill Monroe first wrote this song, he did it slow in that three-quarter time, right? The whole song, kind of sad sounding almost. And then Elvis Presley came along and recorded Blue Moon of Kentucky, but he did a fast version. And after Bill Monroe heard his fast version and of course got a lot of attention, he thought, man, that sounds kind of cool. So he went back and re-recorded it, started it slow, and then kicked it in the fast. And this is the version we're going to do for you. Blue Moon of Kentucky.
Blue Moon of Kentucky, keep on shining. Shine on the one that's gone and proved untrue. Blue Moon of Kentucky, keep on shining. Shine on the one. And left me blue. It was on a moonlit night. The stars were shining bright. They whispered up on high, your love to say goodbye. Blue moon of Kentucky, keep on shining. Shine. The one that's gone and left me blue.
1, 2, 3. Fine job. So you can hear how we started it slow in that three-quarter time and then kicked it up fast into that 4/4 time.
And yeah.
A lot of times when we play that song anywhere, you can see when we kick it up fast, you can see them feet start to pat on the floor. Everybody patting them feet or clapping them laps. It's a lot of fun.
Yeah.
So Mr. Bill Monroe, as you know, the father of bluegrass music, very famous from right down the road in Roseanne, Kentucky. The second song we wanted to do was by Merle Travis. Right now, he was from Muhlenberg County in Kentucky, down the road. Yeah, Muhlenberg County, yeah. Just down the road, not too far from here as well. He was famous for the thumb picking style of music, and but he got influenced by a lot of people. Well, we were going to talk about Arnold Schultz, yeah. weren't we? Arnold Schultz is a name you want to remember because Arnold Schultz was an African American. He lived in Ohio County. He traveled around some, but I think he lived in Ohio County. He was a big influence on Bill Monroe. As a matter of fact, Bill Monroe said he helped him put the blues in bluegrass music because when Bill was younger, he grew up playing with Arnold at square dances, and Arnold played fiddle, he played the guitar, but sometimes when he would play guitar, he would do these blues songs, and it really, Bill loved that sound, so he incorporated it into his music.
And you can hear that in that song, Sitting Alone in the Moonlight.
Sitting Alone in the Moonlight. Yeah, it's a good bluesy sound song. So he influenced Bill Monroe. He also influenced thumb picking. Now, we don't have to get into all of that. You know, not that he started thumb picking, but he had an influence on a little bit of the sound. Some of those guys were doing the thumb picking down in Muhlenberg County. But the guy who made it famous was Merle Travis. Merle Travis had a record deal, came out with a lot. He wrote, he was a big songwriter, and also recorded a lot of albums back in the day. And he wrote this song, but Tennessee Ernie Ford had the big hit on this song. It's called 16 Tons. And if you listen to the words, it's about working in the coal mines. Now down there in Muhlenberg County is where my wife's family is from. My mother and father-in-law grew up down in that area, and there, my wife's grandparents, grandfathers, actually worked in that coal mine. And it's funny because if you listen to the words of this song, there's a part in there that says, I owe my soul to the company store. So they had a company store where the employees could come in and get things. And right here in this house upstairs, we have a bed that came from the company store. And it is branded on the inside of the bed underneath of it. It's kind of cool.
That's cool.
So this is part of my family, so I love to tell that story. But this is a song Tennessee Ernie Ford had several years ago, a big hit. But written by Merle Travis, great thumb picker from down in Muhlenberg County. Let's do a little 16.
Let's do it.
A body that's strong, you know, 16 tons. What do you get? Another day older and deeper in debt. St. Peter, don't you call me, cause I can't go. I owe my soul to the company store. Number 9 coal and the straw man said, well, blessing my soul, you load 16 ton. What do you get? Another day older and deeper in debt. St. Peter, don't you call me, cause I can't go. I owe my soul to the company store. Sixteen times, what do you get? Another day older and deeper in debt. St. Peter, don't you call me, cause I can't go. I owe my soul to the company store. A lot of men didn't, and a lot of men died. With one fist of iron, another of steel. If the right one don't get you, then the left one will. You know, 16 times, what do you get? Another day older and deeper in debt. St. Peter, don't you call me, cause I can't go. I owe my soul to the company store.
I do too. You know, the Thumb Pickers Hall of Fame is down in Muhlenberg County, so if a person wanted to visit that, you certainly could. And speaking of Thumb Pickers Hall of Fame, my late brother-in-law, Billy Siggers, was actually inducted into the Thumb Pickers Hall
That's
of Fame.
That's so cool, man.
Yeah, several years ago. So my family, we sure are proud of that fact. So I love that. I love that that my wife's family and their connection down there to the thumb picking and to the Muhlenberg County sound, and I just very proud of that. So speaking of, let's keep on going about that Muhlenberg County sound.
Yeah.
And the Everly Brothers, because part of the thumb pickers was Ike Everly, was a great thumb picker as well. Ike Everly was the father of the Everly Brothers, which, as some of you all probably know, they was a rock and roll band, but they also had some crossover country hits.
Mm-hmm.
Something I just recently found out, Wayne, and I don't know, you may know about this already, I never realized that they actually did some touring and opening some shows for Bill Monroe.
I didn't know that. That's pretty cool.
I know. So here Bill Monroe is, well, back in the day, before they started calling his music bluegrass, for a while, you know, they was calling Bill Monroe's music country before they stamped the bluegrass name on it. But at some point, he had the Everly Brothers opening some shows for him. So they were that rock and roll country kind of mix. They were that, you know, so they had hits on rock and roll Billboard, but also on country Billboard radio in the day. But man, this is one of my favorite Everly Brothers songs. I don't know about you, but
it's pretty good.
It's pretty good. They had a lot of good songs.
They did.
But this is a beautiful song, one called Dream.
Anytime, night or day. trouble is. Gee whiz, I'm dreaming my life away. I need you so that I could die.
Job well and everything, Wayne. I just love your singing, and we nickname him Smiley. As you can tell, he smiles all the time.
Yeah,
that's a good thing. You're a happy person.
It hurts when I frown.
Oh man! So, you know, John Prine was actually not from Muhlenberg County, but he had some family.
Some ties in Muhlenberg County.
So his family. Was from Muhlenberg County in a little town called Paradise. And if you all know John Prine, you know one of his biggest hits was the song called Paradise, which we're fixing to do for you. But something interesting is this is kind of a true story. If you listen to the words, it's kind of like the coal company came in and kind of destroyed the whole town. They bought it out and just kind of stripped it all. And anyway, it's interesting. Recently, I went down there. Because rumor has it that in this song, he says, when I die, I want you to take my ashes. How does it say?
Let my ashes float down the Green River.
Float down the Green River. So rumor has it that he passed away last year, that he took half his ashes and had them spread at the Green River right down there in Paradise. And so I was able to go down there and see that area where that is in Paradise, and I thought that was kind of cool.
Yeah.
And then the other half of his ashes he had buried in Chicago, where his mother and father are buried. But anyway, I thought that's kind of interesting. So this is definitely a tie to Muhlenberg County and local music. So we thought we'd do you a little Paradise by John Prine.
Let's do it.
I was a child, my family would travel down to western Kentucky, where my parents were born. There's a backwards old town that's often remembered, so many times that my memories are worn. But Daddy, won't you take me back to Muhlenberg County, down by the Green River, Paradise Lane. I'm sorry, son, but you're too late in asking. Mr. Peabody's coal train has hauled it away. I Sometimes we travel right down the Green River to the abandoned old prison down by Adrian Hill. The air smelled like snakes and we shoot with our pistols. Empty pop bottles was all we would fill. And Daddy, won't you take me back to Nuremberg County, down by the Green River where paradise lay? Well, I'm sorry, son, but you're too late in asking. Peabody's coal train has hauled it away. Then the coal company came with the world's largest shovel. It tortured the timber and stripped all the land. Dug for their coal till the land was forsaken. Wrote it all down as the progress of man. But Daddy, won't you take me back to Nuremberg County, down by the Green River where paradise lay? Well, I'm sorry, son, but you're too late in asking. Mr. Peabody's coal train has hauled it away. Let my ashes float down the Green River. Let my soul roll on up to the Rochester Dam. I'll be halfway to heaven with paradise waiting, just 5 miles away from wherever I am. Daddy, won't you take me back to Nuremberg County, down by the Green River? I'm sorry, son, but you're too late in asking. Mr. Peabody's coal train has hauled it away. Mr. Peabody's coal train has hauled it away.
Yeah. True story,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
It's amazing. It's pretty cool to be able to go back to paradise. Of course, the town's no longer there, but... you know, when you know this song and you grew up listening to this song and go in that area, it's kind of, I don't know.
And everybody around here knows this song. I mean, it's just, right. it's so iconic around here. It's right. Incredible.
It is.
So
there's your Western Kentucky artist medley, so to speak. Well, a lot of great artists come from around this area, and there's a ton more. This is just some of the ones that we've selected here. We hope everybody has enjoyed Happy Jams. Good thing about these videos, you can rewind them, play along, because as you know, the lyrics and the chords are on these songs. So play along, sing along, dance along, just have fun. Thanks for watching, everybody. Thanks again, Wayne, for being on the show.
You.
Y'all have a great day.
God bless.